Hello guys, welcome back to our episode number 2 of Learning UiPath Automation Hub. Now in this episode number 2, we are going to see how we can create a process design document using Task Capture. But before we get started, I would like to call out in our previous session, we have completed a first process of Automation Hub, wherein we log in, we submit an idea, and we have submitted an employee-driven idea. And then after submitting employee-driven idea, I have assigned it to Shripad, who is a manager in the Automation Hub, and he will be reviewing the document, and then he will complete the procedure of approval, and then creating a process design document using Task Capture. So today we have Shripad with us for taking this process further with the episode number 2. So over to you, Shripad.
Hey, thanks, Nisarg. Very good evening, guys. That's the Automation Hub web page for me. And I see a couple of actions on my name wherein I need to go ahead and review it. We had our own review of the automation. Now it's time to go ahead and update the comments. Okay. So I will go into the automation profile where we had captured the resume screening details. Okay, that's the description of the automation that we intend to do. That's the high level assessment, and the score is 72%. Looks good. That's the comments box where I need to put in my comments, and that's the action. So I'm going ahead and approving the idea. Okay, when I'm approving this idea, it clearly tells me that it's not a duplicate of another automation. It is adequate to be considered for automation, and all the details are verified, and it's a reliable information. So I just go ahead and update it. Wonderful. The idea is being updated and is approved. All right.
Perfect.
Now, Nisar, the idea has been approved. All right. I'm going to leave my comments over here. Idea is approved. Start with Task Capture. If you see this, you're invited to launch the assessment. That's the message which I've got from the Automation Hub, right?
Yes, and I have also received an email report.
Fantastic. That's good. So we are on the right track now. And what we'll do is, as I am the manager of Automation Hub, and it's a process that I would like to go ahead and showcase on the Task Capture. Okay. That's the documentation tab that I'm going to click on. That's the badge that I'm getting, commentator one, post one comment. All right. So I'm going into the documentation. All right. This is where I'm going ahead and creating a process for you. All right. This is the sample input document which Nisarg had already uploaded earlier. So let's go ahead and do the task capture. Now when I'm going ahead and clicking on task capture, this is the pop-up that I get. In case the pop-ups have been blocked, please make sure that it's unblocked so that you can open this particular application. In case if task capture is not installed in your desktop or your laptop, you need to go ahead and follow the below screen steps so that you can go ahead and install it. I'm going ahead and clicking on Open Task Capture. And it's loading. There you get it. Now, I do want to record it. Okay. I want to record it as part of a simple template. Okay. So I'm going ahead and clicking on Simple Template. That's the Start button. This is when you're adding rows. This is when you're adding sequence. This is when it's a decision box. You want to end it, and this is when you need to capture the sequence. So these are a couple of if you have done Visio, then you would know these are the couple of DAGs that you could use to go ahead and create a process. Okay, I'm going to start off with adding a sequence. Now when I'm adding a sequence, you already get a row around over here. So my first sequence would be to read email. Okay, I'm going to start capturing the actions now. So I'm clicking on actions now. Okay. Now I'm launching Outlook. I'm going ahead and opening the particular email. This is the subject line that I'm going to refer to. And this is the attachment. I'm going to save all attachment, right? Couple of steps getting captured. And I think that's where I'm done. So these are the steps that have been captured. Now, if you see onto my right pane, there are these steps that have been captured wherein I can put in a step title and a description. In case if I think that these particular steps are not relevant, I can go ahead and delete them, all right? That's my process step done for email, okay? So execution time is 27.5 seconds. 9 steps, these are all keyboard stroke level steps that we have done. Now the next sequence would be to open the PDF document, okay? And extract the same on an Excel sheet, okay? And now the next one is going to be update the CRM, okay? Now here we don't have a CRM, okay, because that's going to showcase our company's critical data. So we have used rpachallenge.com as a CRM, wherein data will be pulled from the Excel sheet and updated in the application. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to capture actions now. Okay, so I have got all the steps captured: read email, open PDF, and update CRM. So total around 31 plus 9, 40, 57 steps captured.
So now this is perfect. And I think we have captured entire process into one process design document where you have designed like a PDD. So this is not a like PDD, but there's like a visual, overview of a process. So that helps definitely for a developer. Of understanding the process, and from BA, it's very easy to define a process.
Okay, sounds good. So what's next?
So let's save it and let's upload it.
Yeah, I've saved it. So I'm going back to Automation Hub.
And now let's save it in Task Capture and let's see if it automatically gets updated. So let's go back to Task Capture.
So let's do it from here. So to render images. I think the rendering takes a long time. So
yes.
Could be now the challenge.
Already started uploading, as you see. So this is the faster way, I think.
Let's see.
So it shows that it has export option of your iPad Studio. I'm wondering like whether it creates a workflow for me also. So it saves a lot of time, right?
It will create a skeleton of the bot, okay?
Okay.
In a XAML format. But that is totally upon the developer whether he wants to use it. But yes, couple of steps can be used, okay? Where the keystrokes are used, all right? So something of that sort can be surely used. So publish to Automation Hub, copy link, open it browser. There you go. Two documents uploaded.
Wonderful.
One by Shipak, one by NSF. Okay. So we are good with this particular update now. So, okay.
So that's wonderful that we have created a complete process design document in UiPath Task Capture, which automatically integrated somehow with UiPath Automation Hub. And that's wonderful because Shripath has just displayed how we can create a process design document and also process map. So thank you, Shripath, for this wonderful demonstration. It was really helpful and it was really catchy to see that how these integrations work together.
Yep. So when you go back to the overview, okay, it says phase and status idea approved. You can follow it and you can upvote it. All right. And at the same time, if you just scroll down, it talks about the media. So it shows you the process workflow. And if you go back, as and when you keep on adding documents, this is where it, you would see the entire display. It you can see my comments also here, all right? Now, the next one is already done, okay? And in our next video, we're going to share more details around the next action, all right?
Yeah, sounds wonderful. Thank you, Sripad, for such a lovely demonstration, and happy automation, guys. Thank you.
Yep, I got another badge, supporter one.
Wonderful. Yes. I will collect mine too.
Cool stuff. Good night. Bye. Bye.